Hello and welcome back to another episode of Jurassic World Evolution. As you can see, we're back on Nublar 93 and I have flooded the valley. So in this one I was thinking I would do a series of islands in the lake, and I chose to do the Jurassic World buildings and everything because I wanted to use the monorail to get from island to island, and that's a little bit difficult. So as you can see here, we have flattened and flooded everything, and I am going to just put in a few, because that's the other thing I wanted to make sure that we had enough space for, and we don't. So I wanted to put two monorail stations in, and I also wanted to put in where are you? Security. There's security. And put in like a security centre, so people coming into the park have to be checked. So I think that's going to be a common thing here. So I'm going to build that there. We will connect the path to there, and I'm effectively just going to have to make this a bit bigger. So go to landscape, out to there, I am still in the water. And I'll fix that up in a bit. I had it blue a moment ago. This is probably going to be a bit more difficult than I originally expected. So we have one there. And one there. Actually, no, that's a bad idea. We'll take that out, because I've just realized I won't be able to actually put anything in the track. So, and then go back to landscaping. Make that green. My initial plan was to have two side by side, one going up to the guest island, and then the other one going to the island where the work where all the work happens. The employee section, I should say. So, and we can still do that, it's just going to take a bit more of a refined approach. So if I put you there, and just connect that to there, I will neaten it all up eventually, and then okay, back into operations, we will have a so then what I'm also thinking, I will do two greenhouses. No, don't want to guess. We want a Hammond incubation lab. I want to put that there. Oh, that's just perfect. And then operations again. Please be, please fit. So yeah, I'm thinking we'll do the paleobotany. Even though I'm doing this, I won't be able to actually... we won't actually be able to use them because we can't... I don't think we can grow the things, because I need to grow the feeders, because I need the arrangers to stock it, but we'll muddle through. So enclosures, so this is going to go out and around into the water, so I don't have to almost. Oh well. Okay, and we will do one feeder there, one feeder here, and this feeder here. Now we will have to be careful because I have allowed for carnivores to eat normally. Okay, we'll set this up. Some big trees. So my law for this park is that while they were experimenting with different forms of power, they decided to try and build a dam on the other side of the island, and after flooding it and finding that they didn't really have enough, it just wasn't good enough and it wasn't going to work, they decided to, I'm just gonna put normal trees in, they just decided they would use the area to build a new park. So let's so that's one island done. We will do hatchery capacity and the speed. There is no failed incubations on, so that should be fine. That's going back and forth, so there we go, that's one island done. And then, is this about the middle? Just try and make it not as uniform as possible. So there's a lake there, well, island there, sorry. Right, I am going to, oop, wrong one. Yeah, I'm just going to build that out a little bit because I do want to put another monorail station on here. I am pretty much just going to have to put it like this and then have a monorail station come this way, and then what I'm also thinking is have one over here. My logic will become obvious. Soon. So, we'll have a couple of hotels over. Over here. And then kind of have this flex around like so, and then in this area we'll have a bar looking over there, store. Restaurant, toilet facility, kind of like Main Street. So have the bowling alley in there as well. And I was thinking, why have I got no path connection? That's quite frankly because I haven't connected this path. There we go. Just got some palm trees around. Around the beach. And also because the dinosaurs can escape, what am I obstructed by? Life? There we go, one over there, and one over there. So all the rock, all the... just everything's just been shoved into this lake to help build a structure. Okay, so right, let's not paths. So what I'm going to do for a couple of these, the closer islands anyway, I'm going to connect them by a very wide path. And then we go back into landscaping with the water. So it's like a sandbar. I'm going to have a series of islands going off close by, and then the bigger main islands can kind of go a bit closer. So this whole back part's going to be an enclosure. And then, do I have a viewing platform? Well, viewing gallery there. One there. And if I could put one this side, would be fantastic. Yes. So, one enclosure. I'm not going to do all the enclosures today. This is just going to be a rough idea of what we can do, and just the general look we're going to try to achieve. Thank you. And then, actually, let's just try and there's one there. Tiny one there. So I probably need to delete these palm trees because they'll be in the way. One, delete, go. And then if I can actually get a path to go around that though. Nope. To there. Thick path going. There to there. And then no, not paths. And then of course that would have the monorail going there. I should be able to. Nope. Oh, I technically I can. Right, I think this is going to be a bit of a tangled mess, but we'll get there eventually. if I put that one there and then have this everything's too sharp. I'm no good at building monorail tracks. There we go. And then no! I keep doing that. It wasn't too sharp. And then I have this one . So we have one, we have two largish islands, well, three large islands, and then four smaller ones. If I can find another bit of space to put another island. Actually. Here's one. And we'll just go guests. Boom. So, I think we've got the general layout done. In the next episode, what I'll do is I'll add all the island characteristics and hills and all that, and add the enclosure fences, and then we'll decide who's going to live where given the amount of space we have. These obviously be tiny friendlier dinosaurs, maybe something a little bit aggressive, we'll see. And then the bigger islands on the side for larger attractions. So please leave a like, comment and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this episode and I hope you're excited to see where we go with it. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.